you've had a bit of a break. You've had this fantastic momentum that you've gathered beforehand, 3 wins out of 4. What have you been doing to ensure that momentum is maintained?
Well, after the Leicester game, we had one free day. Then we were back in. We did 3 good days of work. Got some more physical work into the players. They trained really well. Then they had a couple of days off over the weekend. And then we've been building into this game. So we started training on Monday. And with tomorrow's session, we will have done 5 training sessions going into the game. We did some remedial work on the Leicester performance, both in the video room and on the training ground. But all of this week has been, you know, preparing for the game that we have against Chelsea on Saturday.
Has it been a chance to get everybody fit?
Yeah, it's been a good opportunity to get extra training load into them, more tactical information across to the players. So it's been an extremely valuable time. See, when I came in on the 3rd of January, the first day I had a game, and then it's game, and this has been the first real opportunity to get good amount of training work into them without a game in between.
And you met the fans last night, I think, in a forum. How did that go?
Yeah, it was positive. You know, and the feel around the club is positive at the moment, with the supporters in and around the city, that the people that I meet are pleased the way the team are playing and that are picking up some valuable points. So I enjoyed the evening. I attended along with two of the players, Jack Cork and Leon Britton, and my other assistant coaches. And, yeah, we all enjoyed the evening.
Going back to Chelsea, given your associations with the club, how special a game is this for you personally?
Yeah, I mean, it is. I am really looking forward to going back in a coaching capacity. I had 2 spells at the club, 95 to 2000, working part-time, and then full-time between 2007-2011. I had lots of different roles. You know, the last 2 years were very memorable, because I was working at senior level with Carlo. In 2009-2010, I was part of a very special team that won the double, something that's very rare in English football. So something I'll always look back at very fondly. Still keep in touch with some of the people that work at the club, and it'd be really nice to go back.
You were on the inside, and they continued their success since you've left. What's the secret of Chelsea's success? What's the thing that you really admire from working there?
Well, you know, before me, during my time, and after me, they've continued to recruit good managers, head coaches with a lot of experience who are winners, and, you know, most importantly, have continued to invest in the team. The team's very different now to when I was there. I think probably just John Terry really is the one that, from my time with Ivanovic, you know, recently moving on. David Luiz as well, I know, and Matic. But, you know, they always evolve, they invest, they get good players in. They've got very good players at the moment, and when you get a mixture of good coach with good players, it's a very good mix.
Do you think they'll win the title?
Well, they're in a very, very good position. You know, people are saying, is it over, is it not over? Chelsea won't think it's over, and the teams behind them will not think it's over. But they've got themselves in a very strong position. They had an excellent run recently where they were winning game after game, home and away. And they deserve to be in the position they're in based on the way they've been playing.
Looking at them this season, do you notice a difference in them under Antonio Conte than previous seasons or not?
Well, I think they're obviously playing a different formation. He started off with 4 defenders and then went back to a system that he's been very familiar with over the last few years with the national team and also Juventus as well. That's seen some players that were maybe fringe players and even players that are out on loan emerge as starting players, and I'm talking about Alonso and Moses particularly. You know, so fair play to him. That was a bold decision to both change the shape and also put in some players that were not, hadn't been so consistent selection for the coaches previously. So, you know, he has done a very, very good job.
Is he a guy you admire? You ran into him, I think, at Madrid, didn't you, in the Champions League?
Played against Juventus in the Champions League with Real Madrid, and he's a player that Carlo knew very well as a player, because he played for him when he was the coach at Juventus, and Conte was in the team. And he said even as a player, you know, he was very, very driven, very motivated, and he's not surprised that he's gone on to do what he has as a coach.
Different character to you on the touchline. At the height of your joy the other day, you gave a modest little fist pump in appreciation. He tends to let it all hang out, doesn't he?
Yeah. He is an emotional coach on the side, and obviously works for him. Klopp's similar. I'm a little bit more restrained, and you know, there's a lot to take in, and I try and concentrate on what's happening. But clearly, in some recent games, I've showed my pleasure at the getting a good result.
In terms of the way your team is playing, Paul, you think back a few weeks ago, the idea of someone like Alfie Mawson coming up against Diego Costa, Hazard, that would have filled some Swansea fans with a lot of trepidation. How pleased are you with the transformation in people like Alfie Mawson?
Yeah, he's one of a number of players that I think have stepped up their performances. And you know, it has very much been a team effort, and when the team are organised and we're defending from the front, everyone knows their responsibilities, it's easier. I mean, Alfie hasn't got a massive amount of experience, but he's shown in recent games he has a lot of potential, and he's playing well, and he needs to keep his form up by working hard and staying focused. And I see that in him at the moment.
You confident he can do the job again this
week?
Yeah,
you can't do it alone. I'm confident that he can do his part. That's why he's in the team at the moment. He's getting pushed hard in training every day by Jordi Amat and Mike van der Hoorn, as is Fernandez as well. We've got a good backup in those positions. But confident that he'll do his part, but everyone's going to have to play well on Saturday if we're going to have to get something out of this game.
Paul, given what you knew about Antonio Conte, have you been surprised how quickly an impact he has made? Are you surprised to see Chelsea top with a new coach in place just a matter of months?
No, not really. I think other coaches have done it at other clubs. Mourinho did it in his first year at Chelsea. Carlo did it in his first year at Chelsea. He's not unique in that situation. He is clearly a very good coach, and he's got very good players to work with. It's a good combination, and they deserve to be top based on the good results that they've had.
And you say others will still feel they're in the race for the title, but it's theirs to lose, isn't it?
Yeah, when you've got that kind of gap, of course. But still, 13 games, a lot of points to play for. And stranger things have happened, and they certainly won't be taking their foot off the gas. And the teams behind them won't. They want to stay in touch for as long as they can until it's mathematically impossible.
For Swansea City in their in your position, is this a shot to nothing almost?
Well, that might have been the case going to Liverpool and going to Manchester City as well, but I think both those teams would say we gave them hard games. See, we came out in one situation with a positive result and one in a negative result. In both situations, we worked very hard, and I think we'd give anyone a difficult game in this moment.
You were talking, we were talking to Fernandez after the last game, Federico Fernandez, and he was talking about maybe signing a new contract. Has that happened yet? Or
no, still not quite there, but things are moving in a very positive direction.
Do you expect it to happen in the next
week? Hopefully soon. I can't say exactly when, but the talks are positive, and I don't see any reason why it won't happen.
And Borja Bastón, what is the position with him? Some speculation this week that maybe in the summer he could go back to Spain. Have you thought that far ahead yet?
No, absolutely. No. After the window closed, and they're the players that are going to be here till the end of the season, and no discussions about any players about the summer at this point, only focusing on getting the right results.
Does he still have a part to play in this run-in?
No, of course. I mean, the squad's not that big. I think what do we have today? We've got 20 fit outfield players. That's not a massive amount. A couple more injuries and the squad's coming down even further. So, everyone's training, everyone's pushing hard. They need to be ready.
Do you feel it's been tough for him because he was a record signing, that comes with a pressure in itself, I suppose.
Yeah, I think the transition has been hard for him. It's not a unique situation where someone's come from different country. He's got to adapt to the language, the culture, different style of football. La Liga is very different to the Premier League, the pace of it. He did well last year with the goals he scored at Eibar. And we need to help him, and he needs to find the form that he's going to be confident again and show that he can score goals.
And does that come through just a goal, maybe even off the back of his leg or whatever, something like that? Can that, with a striker, can that be a catalyst?
Yeah, it's difficult to say what could be the changing moment. But he is working hard in training, and that's all he can do at the moment until he gets an opportunity to go on the pitch.
Ryan Giggs was in Wales this week saying that he felt it was difficult for British managers to get a chance, certainly in the top level. You were saying last night to the fans that you've been for this job three times, really, but now you've got it. Do you feel he's got a point that it is still tough for homegrown coaches, managers to be given a chance?
Yeah, to a degree, yes. Difficult for homegrown players, academy players, English players. This is a global market. The games are going out all over the world. We're able to recruit players from all over the world. So it's a very competitive marketplace. There's only 20 coaches. And how many coaches are there, working out there in the world that would love to work at this level? So it is very competitive. My view would be you want to see the best foreign coaches coming to work here, and outside of that, opportunities for British managers, of course.
Do you feel maybe the first instinct of a club these days is to look abroad rather than to look within?
I think it varies from club to club. A lot of the clubs have, we're no different to that, have foreign ownership. Very difficult to say how every individual club looks at that situation.
Going to Chelsea, obviously with your fond connections with them, does that make this a game that you want to win more, or would you rather have punished somebody else this weekend if the opportunity arose?
No, whoever we're playing this weekend, it's a game that I want to win. It doesn't matter that it's Chelsea or it's Burnley next week. It doesn't make any difference. It's just nice for me personally that I'd worked there for so many years and I still know people there that I get opportunity to go back and coach at that club, against that club. It's a real honour for me.
You could be fizzing inside, but you put a very good face on it. I wonder how excited you are about facing Chelsea.
No, I am, absolutely. And the players are, and Claude McAlealy is, going back there, and the rest of the backroom staff. We're all very excited by this challenge, and we're not daunted by it either. We've got to go there confident, try and put on a good performance. We know it's going to be a really difficult task. Probably no one's expecting us to win. That takes the pressure off to a certain degree, but we put our own pressure on us to make sure that we're continuing to try and improve all the time, because we're in decent run of form, and we want to keep our confidence high, and that means putting in a good performance, even if we don't get the result that we're really looking for.
As a coach, do you look at the season? I know you haven't had a full season here, but the week's going by. Do you look at it in terms of sections? Obviously this is going to be a tough one against Chelsea. Do you look in terms of thinking, well, whatever we get from this will be great? I've now got to be looking at the games we've got with the teams who are around us in the lower half of the table. Do you think along those lines? Do you think in those sort of sections, or is it literally the next game in front of you?
Yeah, it is. In terms of the preparation, it's absolutely the next game. All the effort that goes in on the training field, the planning, the analysis is all about the next game. But clearly I know what's happening after Chelsea in the four games that we've got and how big those four games are.
Do you give any reminders to players at this stage, if they needed it, that those games are coming up and they could be a defining point in a season?
No, the only thing I've said to the players is we've got 13 games to go now. We've got ourselves in a good position. How hard are we willing to work to make sure that we're continuing to improve? How much do we want to avoid suffering at the end of the season? Because, unless we keep winning and moving up the table, then we're going to be in a position where, you know, two games to go, we need 4 points. And in those situations, the pressure is very, very high. We want to try and get as much of the work done when the games provide you that opportunity to get points. And the next opportunity to get points is on Saturday. And that's, we'd be naive to look any further than that.
I wonder, you know, as a coach, you've got to keep an eye on every player and the way they're feeling and things. Was there any worry? I mean, it's been a great run for you since you've been here, and, you know, congratulations on that. But was there any worry that you might see any degree of complacency start to creep in, that people might start thinking, well, actually, we probably are safe now because we've put in some decent wins together? Have you had to jump on that at all, stamp that out? Were you worried that it might come in at all? Or?
No, not at all. I think players have been very professional, very focused. They know that there's a massive amount of work to be done. I smell that in them. And what I see in training is they're pushing and pushing and pushing. And we all know together that there's a long, long way to go. And as quick as we've got into this position, we can fall back into that unless we continue to work very hard.